There's three old people.
Your firm gets credit?
No, sir.
Nor anybody else.
River City Station, next stop, River City, Iowa.
Went out the window with the mail that cut the straw full of bottles of soap. Chased the approach of the truck.
live in this town.
Yeah, I like it too. I mean, it's not Brooklyn, New York. It's not the city of Brooklyn churches.
Brooklyn. This ain't even New York. Hey, are you hiding out or something?
Nah, just not as late on my feet as I used to be as when I was working street right. You know, in your business, there are a lot of close dates. I got a nice job now and a nice girl. That's from Poppelmeyer, the boss.
So you sound legitimate, huh? I always knew you were up to no good.
So what are you in now? Last I heard you were selling steam automobiles.
I was.
What happened?
Someone actually invented one.
No.
Well, now I'm back to the old Finn.
Not kids vans. Well, they got no need for kids vans in this town. Whatever these Iowa folks don't already have, they do with that.
They got music?
Yeah, they have the gramophone down at the barbershop and a second library in
piano.
Yeah, maiden lady. Oh, still looks good before you get this bag on pack.
Now, Mars, you know maiden lady librarians are a specialty of mine. You just point out to me the minute you see her and I'll back her into a corner and breathe on her glasses.
There she goes.
Well, I'll do it, but I won't like it.
That's not the librarian. That's Mrs. Finn, the mayor's wife. Good morning, Mrs. Finn.
Don't change the subject.
Is that what's the matter?
Same thing as the matter. It's always the matter here. Look, is this the book you give my daughter to read? The Groovy Hat of Omar Khayyam? I'm appalled.
I did recommend it. It's beautiful Persian poetry.
It's dirty Persian poetry. People lying around in woods, eating sandwiches, getting drunk, drinking directly out of jugs, with innocent young girls, no daughter of mine.
Mrs. Shin, The Rubat of Omar Khayyam is a classic.
It's a smutty book, like most of the rest of people around here, I dare say.
Honestly, Mrs. Shin, wouldn't you rather have your daughter read a classic than Eleanor or R.L. Stein?
What R.L. Stein reads is her mother's concern. Just you keep your smutty books away from my daughter.
Cigarette pink and bragging about how they're trying to cover up the telltale breast of sex. One fine night,
Yes, it is. Now Is this scene?
Okay.
spell Dusa?
Dusa!
All came to town with a very famous story.
Yeah.
And I love you madly, madly. Edison didn't get it right the first time. So what's the difficulty?
Well, when you hold it tight enough to see the music study, you cut off the circulation and you can't even wriggle your fingers.
Well, I still say it needs a little more work. Want to go check out some prospects with me?
Me? Yeah, you could go blind.
Well, want to go check out some prospects with me?
You mean you're going in there?
I don't see a quarantine sign.
I got a hint from the professor. See you later, I hope.
Ding dong!
Listen a minute, are you soliciting? You haven't got a license.
Why no? I, collect doorbells, and this one has an unusual tone quality.
Flattery will not avail you. Soliciting is statutory in this county. Now please just get out of permit. Why haven't you been over to City Hall with your license?
I must have done this.
None of your hours.
you, little bro.
Has he gone?
He has, and I hope not forever. Darling, don't you ever think of your future?
Mama, now Mama, a girl's future doesn't depend on encouraging every fast-talking, self-centered, woman-chasing man who comes to town.
All right, darling, all right. But it's a well-known principle that if you keep steel in one door and flint in another, you'll never strike much of a fire. Mama! A fine-looking man and well-educated, too. Gary, Indiana Conservatory, class of Art 5.
The fact that he claims his commodity in this particular case is music does not impress me, nor does anything else about him.
Library.
Ladies' Dance Committee meets Tuesday night. They'll be counting on you. If there's anything you don't see, please be sure to ask for it.
Wow.
He's dead. Oh, Rebecca Hill, I didn't see you.
May I join you?
Well, really, I don't think.
Where are they? You're seen red-handed, caught in the act. Take your hands off my daughter.
Papa!
And you got it scared of you.
Sorry, Professor, but we've got our orders. Professor, we've been deputized.
Yes, yes. Well, congratulations. Now, let me see. What do I have here? Every time I try to give you fellows those credentials, you always try to change the subject somehow. Well, I'll just go to my room and get them.
Sorry, Professor, but I'm afraid we'll have to go with you.
Well, let me see. Let me see if I have my keys. Well, what's this? Oh, a testimonial from the only female ever to appear on the Red Cap Circuit, Madame Rainier. That's her stage name, of course. Really from Malone. Lyda Rose Quackenbush.
Let me see that.
Lyda Rose. You'll never forget a name like that, Lyda Rose, just like the old song.
Look at that now.
Lyda Rose.
Yes,
please don't let me keep you. You must have more important things to do than explain the sphinx system to me.
No, no, not that I can think of. Now, now let's sit down.
I must be very... dull company for a man of your experience.
No, no, where'd you get an idea like that?
One hears rumors about traveling salesmen.
One... Now, Miss Mary, you mustn't believe everything you hear. After all, one hears rumors about librarians.
I suppose you're referring to Uncle Matty.
Uncle Matty?
Yes, my father's best friend. No matter what they say, he left the library to me so that my mother and Winthrop could have security. Surely you don't believe...
Oh, no, 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 Miss Marion. Why do you suppose people start these rumors?
Never mind this. Jealousy. Jealousy mostly, I guess.
Exactly. And why do you expect people start rumors about... That's probably why people start rumors about traveling salesmen.
So what have you heard? Just that, well, it stands to reason. Why, take you for instance. If your attention to a customer or a piano teacher was misconstrued, they could be downright lies, couldn't they?
What could?
Rumors and things.
Well, what? Why, of course.
Oh, it just goes to show you should never believe everything you hear. If you just discuss things...
Miss Marion, I'd be delighted to discuss anything in the world with you. Well, couldn't we sit? You do sit, don't you?
I suppose we could sit on the steps.
Or at the hollow log at the footbridge.
Oh, no, I couldn't do that. I've never been to the footbridge with a man in my life.
Just to talk.
Oh, I have to change for the sociable.
The meaning of the footbridge is 15 minutes.
I can't. 15 minutes. Mama! Mama!
What?
gonna back down now?
No, but I promised Winthrop and Mama a plate of ice cream. You go up on ahead. I'll be down in a minute.
And now the high water mark of this evening's festivities. The ladies, your resident dance group will now present their interpretation of Grecian urn. Grecian urn.
Indiana State Journal.
Back.
Yeah.
That's what I collected all those $300 in uniform money just
this without Andrea here every day keeping me organized.
Thank you.